So I'm just opening the trading rules which we have discussed earlier. So for everyday's market commentary, we'll be using those trading rules only. So on first hand, we'll go to the daily time frame and then mark the immediate resistance. So here, as you can see, this red line, which is R2 on daily time frame. So if I remove and plot it again, so this is our immediate resistance for Nifty. So there we'll mark an horizontal line. So then and there itself, you can apply RSI also and check for any divergences on a higher time frame. So yes, here Nifty is kind of making a bearish divergence. It's a very mild bearish divergence, but it can have some impact on Nifty either today or in the next week, because today is expiry. So this is the story of Nifty in daily time frame. Now let's go to lower time frame, that is hourly time frame. And here also, this red line R2 is our next resistance. So on weekly also we have marked the resistance. Even on weekly time frame, we can see a very large bearish divergence here. Here the divergence is very clear. You can mark it either here or just make sure that on price axis and on RSI axis, the points are in the same vertical line. So on weekly time frame also, we can see, on hourly time frame also, we can see a bearish divergence being formed, and that too near the pivot point R2. So for this whole week, that is 23rd to 27th, we'll have one pivot point, weekly pivot point. So near to that point, we are having a bearish divergence now. Let's see what Nifty is going to do today or by tomorrow, because tomorrow is the last day of this week. Now going into lower time frame. So in lower time frame also, that is today's pivot points are saying that price is below this central pivot point, which is a bearish zone. And in RSI also, price is in between 40 to 60, which is a sideways zone. So there's no much movement in Nifty today as of now. So our view for today is Nifty sideways to bearish, because the three points have confirmed to us the same. Let's apply another indicator also and then finally come to a conclusion. I'm choosing MACD for this. Moving average, convergence and divergence. So even here also, a break under has happened. Cross under also we can say that. So fast line, MACD line has crossed under this signal line, which is also a bearish signal. So for today, Nifty is neutral to bearish view. Unless all these points are crossed, we cannot say Nifty is bullish. So first resistance would be this area, 10,300, because it is weekly pivot point. At the same time, there's this little bit price congestion zone here. And also this higher high, which is lifetime high of Nifty, which has formed in the opening candle yesterday. So unless these points are broken, we cannot say Nifty is bullish. So here we saw Nifty is near this weekly R2. So I'll write it down clearly. Near weekly R2, formed bearish divergence on hourly chart. in intraday below central pivot, which is bearish zone, and MACD cross under has happened. Let's see what Bollinger Bands is telling us. So even in Bollinger Bands also, price is now below this 20 moving average, and we also call this zone as bearish zone in Bollinger Bands. So above this central line it is bullish, and below that central line it is bearish. So even Bollinger Bands also in bearish zone below 20 simple moving average. So our view for today on Nifty is neutral to bearish. Yeah, so we have covered all the points here. Only thing is there is no clear candle pattern formation, so that is the reason we have given neutral. Else rest of all the conditions are saying that Nifty is bearish for today. Even on 24th October also we saw when we have started our market commentary, Nifty was around R1 of that intraday, and from there it has given a good 50 point fall. So let's see what it does today. Until the central pivot, that is 292, is not broken, Nifty is still bearish, and it also has 2 to 3 resistances which it needs to cross to become bullish. So final conclusion for Nifty would be neutral to bearish. So let's move to Bank Nifty now. So Bank Nifty on daily time frame is near to previous resistance zone, that we can mark a horizontal line here, or else let's draw a rectangle making it a zone. And I'm enabling the pivot points. So it is above the monthly pivot point, which is 24905. We have marked a horizontal line there. So Bank Nifty would be bullish only above 25100 to 25200. So maximum about 25200 only we can say that Bank Nifty is bullish. So you can also see that it is kind of forming a near doji pattern. So connecting the previous high to this today's high, at the same time previous high to today's high. So even in Bank Nifty there is a bearish divergence on daily time frame. Let's move to lower time frame, which is hourly time frame. So Bank Nifty went near this weekly pivot, which is around 25 to 23. So today's high till now was 25176. So it is in between this R1 and R2. So we have marked pivot point on hourly chart also, that is weekly, and now let's move to intraday time frame. So in intraday, Bank Nifty is above this central pivot point, and as you can see, central pivot point is in confluence zone. And today's intraday pattern also formed a pure bearish divergence here. So yesterday's immediate high with today's opening candle's high. So I'm removing this blue box, it is not clearly visible. Yeah. And at the same time, respective RSI. Say a pure bearish divergence, and now price has took support near the 60 RSI. If it is able to enter the 60-40 zone, then it is purely bearish, and here also it should cross this central pivot point, then Bank Nifty is purely bearish. Until then it is neutral to, we can say only neutral here. So until this 25, 160, 25, 170 is not crossed, it is neutral to bullish only. But this bearish divergence will try to force Bank Nifty to make it move below the central pivot. So pivot points are not saying any clear picture today. On the intraday, it is telling us above central pivot, which is bullish zone. Bearish divergence on daily and intraday chart. So we'll apply one more indicator, MACD. Yeah, MACD cross under has happened in intraday. And next one is Bollinger Bands. So in Bollinger Bands, price is taking support near this central line. So it is still in bullish zone, and now it is taking support here. So if it is able to cross this 20 SMA and central pivot, so a good amount of bearishness will be visible. If cross 20 SMA and central pivot, then it is bearish. And this 20 SMA and central pivot, they are in confluence now. So even there are actually mixed signals in Bank Nifty today. So Bollinger Bands and intraday level pivots are saying that it is in bullish zone, whereas in a higher time frame it has formed a bearish divergence. Even on intraday chart it has formed a bearish divergence. So this is very interesting. We need to see this price movement. So now it is trying to close below the central pivot point. and also this 20 SMA. So let's track this Bank Nifty for today. So I am neutral to bearish. So this was about Nifty and Bank Nifty. So we'll discuss two more stocks. You people can give the list of those stocks.